So what's going on, guys? Liam from Twisted Royals here. Today is a good day. We're gonna cut some eggs. Check it. Like I say, the only clutch we have this season, or maybe not. I'm hoping one more girl will go. She is a spider, cinnamon, orange dream, possible yellow belly, and I decided to put her with the yellow belly to try and prove the yellow belly out in her. Hope for some ivories. That'll be excellent. But yes, so for today, we have a banana cinnamon male to a champagne female. Now, I've heard recently a few breeders I've heard sort of, they don't really like working with champagne, but I personally think it is such a good gene and there's so much more to be done with it. I'm hoping this is just the start of the stuff we do with the champagne gene here. I'm really looking forward to this clutch. I mean, obviously you look forward to every clutch, but as it's the only one here so far this season, I'm fingers crossed, I've got my toes crossed that we hit some really good pairings. So let's go check that out and see what we did.
So guys, as you can see, one has pipped. And the rest are pulled apart very, very easily. That's kind of how you know they're ready to be cut. Obviously, there was issues with incubation. I went through about 3 days with power cuts, had to send them to a friend's incubator. Big up Toby More Matrix, thanks for that. So yeah, let's get into it and see what we have. Let's go for the one that's pipped first of all. I've got the big scissors. The ones will do me. Let's see what we have. Okay, definitely banana, possibly banana cinnamon in there, I would say. The pairing was banana cinnamon to champagne. Wow, looks pretty cool. Awesome, love the purples. Cool. These eggs look a little bit dry. I might have to just put a tiny bit of water in there just to make sure they're all right. Let's put them down. Let's do this one next. Keep knocking the camera, sorry. That. I'm not entirely sure. Should have really looked. I guess would be champagne banana, maybe. Awesome. Let's go for this one. Just roll the membrane off the egg. Same as the first one, whatever that may be. Yep, banana cinnamon again. Wow. I mean, I bought the dad as a full-grown adult, so obviously his colours are sort of faded a bit.
Wow, that's what he looked like when he was a baby cheese.
Crazy. Let's just put in that one. From the start of it. Okay. Got some proper mould gold going on there. It was only five we got in this clutch. No eggs went bad or anything like that. Wow. I think that could be all three genes. I mean, wow. That could be the banana, cinnamon, champagne. Egg. Unbelievable. I think his head's right there. Yeah. No normal so far. Can't believe it. Great odds. Dad has now gone on to past his noon. And Mum is doing really well. She's smashing her food again. Hopefully she'll be ready to go again for next year. That's a champagne banana, maybe? Yeah, I think champagne banana. Yep. No normals. Wow, I can't believe it. Brilliant. No normals. So, let's see what they look like when they come out the egg. So, here we are, guys. Just get this box ready for them. So, yeah. Check these bad boys out. Look, I mean, we couldn't have done much better if we tried. I mean, the odds gods have been awesome to us. Maybe because we've only got one clutch here. Yeah, we had a bit of bad luck. See, I would hope for more females to go this season, but what we have got is a bit of quality, really. So let's try and figure out what we have. See, all we've got them soaking in a bit of water, which is at 32. Just to try and get some of this stuff off. Can't remember what I use now. is vermiculite. I thought I'd use something else for a second. So, let's have a go. Let's get this one out first. I'm guessing, because the banana dad obviously was a male, I'm guessing everything with banana will be male in here. And this, I think, is a banana cinnamon. And I can't believe how different they look. I mean, just hatched compared to when they're full grown. It's just crazy. Let's try and sex him quickly. I'm saying him already. If he's going to work with me. Too many clutches ever, so I don't, you know, don't want to try and hurt them or avoid hurting them, shall I say. Let's just get some white off. So obviously you can see this is the same banana cinnamon. I'll say it again, I can't believe how good they look. Brilliant. This one, it is in the egg. I thought maybe a champagne cinnamon, but out of the egg, I think it's just a straight champagne, maybe. I'm not sure. Never had champagne before. It's a regular. Come in shop. Alright, calm down. Lovely little heads down there. Not sure which I'm holding back yet. I'm letting go. Let's just put them down there. We'll try and get a box. Now these two. Let's go with this one. I think, don't hold me to it, I think these are all three genes. They can't stand still. Try and get off as quick as possible. Pretty sure they are all three. I think it's called a sunrise, if I'm correct. Yeah, they look great. I think I could be holding one of these back. She keeps knocking the camera. Check her out. The camera does not do her head justice. That looks yellow there, and in person it looks like proper orange. Showing up a bit better there, the closer I get to the lens. But like I said, I'm absolutely over the moon with this clutch. Let's put him or her in the tub. Let's hope this one stays a bit stiller. Looking at it through the camera now, I'm not sure. I don't know if they're the same or not. It's hard to tell. Looking at it without the camera, they do look the same, but now looking through, this one could be just a banana champagne. I'll have to get someone's opinion, but nevertheless, whatever it is, it's just so nice. Gorgeous snake. Yeah, guys, so the next video, what I'll do, I'll wait till they're shed and then I will go through how I separate them, put them in their own tubs, how I set their tubs up, whatnot. So yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this video and stay tuned for the next one.
Like I said, I'm going to do another video soon, so stick around for that. And also, I just want to add that I will be starting a podcast. I want to go around to all the breeders. Well, not all the breeders, but I want to get a load of breeders onto a podcast talking about their plans for the future, how well their season's gone this year, things like that, how they got started in this hobby. And so yeah, I've reached out to quite a few people and the response has been very positive, so I'm hoping to get out and about very soon and have the first podcast ready for your listening pleasure, hopefully in maybe 2 weeks to a month's time. And all things going well, I hope to put one out every month. So if you're interested on getting on the podcast as well, drop me a message on Instagram, Facebook, even YouTube, and we'll go from there. But until next time, guys, take it easy. Make sure you're wearing your masks in the shops. And I'll see you soon.